Welcome, rebellious generals. Today's objective is to capture the weapons factory at Harper's Ferry Heights. I'm playing the Confederate campaign on Major General Difficulty and version 1.28.4 of the J&P Mod. Things went well enough besides having a Brigadier General unit officer killed. This is one of the side battles where I tend to lose two officers nearly every time I play it. Before jumping into camp, I want to say thank you for taking the time to check out any of my materials related to the game. I hope that you find something to help you achieve success in your own campaigns. Do not hesitate to ask questions in the comments. Be aware that Colonel, Brigadier General, and Major General difficulties all share an AI profile. Legendary has its own profile. Therefore, things that you see me do should easily translate to lower difficulties, but may not work in Legendary or be suboptimal. Chronologically, the next three battles would be Chantilly, Weapons Factory, and Antietam. However, I'm playing Weapons Factory first because of scaling. I haven't touched my army size since Second Bull Run, and yet scaling shows AI with around 18,000 men for Weapons Factory, over 30,000 for Chantilly, and twice my army size for Antietam. My average infantry size for Second Bull Run was about 1,700 men. I can go to Weapons Factory close to those same unit numbers. So I'll select 15 units for this battle and top off their losses. Then in my next camp, I'll increase my average unit sizes to something more appropriate for Chantilly and Antietam. My two career points from Second Bull Run went into training. That gives me up to 3 points per unit stat for each training event with a cap of 26. I'm going to attempt this battle using all 1-star units except for Scribner's 2-star artillery battery. The 5 infantry units and 4 artillery batteries can feasibly get their 2nd star in the next 2 side battles, giving me more 2 stars for Antietam. DHL is the corps commander. Longstreet has the 1st division with Wilcox, Ford, and Scribner. McLaws has the 2nd division with Roberts, Hobson, and Peabody. Preston has the 3rd division with Thoburn, Owen, and Brooke. Beauregard has the 4th division with Seams, Rowett, and Finnegan. And Ferrero has the 5th division with Latimer, Pickett, and Young. I also maxed out my supply wagon. Even with a full corps reinforcement, the AI has about 15,000 fewer troops than it did at Second Bull Run. Training is about the same, and armory increased a few percent. The AI will have 19,604 troops and 64 guns, plus whatever it gets from unit splits. I have 16,206 men and 68 guns. Based on the numbers, it should be an easy victory, although the AI units should have more experience than mine. Not counting unit splits, the AI should have 5 infantry units, 5 artillery batteries, 3 skirmishers, and 1 cavalry unit. All units are deployed at the start of the battle for both the player and AI. PHB stands for Potomac Home Brigade, and I suspect UDC should be DUDC. I'm not a historian, but the AI units in the game are usually named for actual officers and brigades that were in the war. DUDC was a New York Brigadier General. There are a few ways that you can play this battle. Normally, the AI infantry units will be lined up south of the VP, out in the open, and its skirmishers and cavalry would be in the cover to the left of the VP. My preferred method is to stay to the left of the woods and fight my way into cover, then push the AI units out of cover and out into the open where I can finish them off. However, the AI will sometimes react by moving many of its infantry units into cover, and then it can become more of a slugfest. A second way to play it is to form up my infantry south of the AI infantry, while out in the open and backed up by my artillery. That allows my division of cavalry to easily move up the left side of the battlefield and eliminate the AI cav and skirmishers and then harass from the rear. The downside of that is having any infantry out in the open taking artillery fire, so there's more of a risk to casualties and officers being wounded. Since I still haven't invested in medicine, I usually lose 2 officers in this battle, either wounded or killed. Medicine will become a priority once I finish Antietam. I'm going with my preferred method of staying to the far left and hoping that the AI doesn't move too many units to the left until my cavalry make it out to the rear. Most of the losses at this battle are likely to come from artillery, especially if the AI gets a bunch of artillery unit splits. One thing to keep in mind is that the AI cavalry often charge once the player units are visible. My horse artillery batteries are faster than my infantry, so I need to slow them down a little bit and let my infantry get into place. Here comes the cavalry. I need to move mine up to intercept them. The AI cavalry is split this time. My artillery are catching up again, so I need to figure out where I'm going to place all of them. That unit was surrounded and routing and still was able to ride through my melee KF to safety. I need to get my guys up into cover on the far left and let my KF work on his skirmishers. George Pickett has been wounded. I need to go straight north to avoid canister fire from the northern artillery unit. Then I'll hunt down both cav units. Most of the AI infantry are still in the open, so this should work well once my guys get in place to flank over to the VP. One down and one to go. When you have a tiger by the tail, it's better to not let him go. So my cav will stay in pursuit. The AI units are falling back and out of the good cover. I'll have my KF take out the northern artillery sitting in the open. I'm looking pretty good right now. There is a decent cluster of guns in the rear, so I'd like to keep my cavalry away from that for a bit. I'll just keep using concentrated fire to force each unit to rout out of the cover. I can get some shots in on that forward artillery now. Almost everyone is out of cover now, just a couple of skirmishers left. I want to try and get all the AI units to wavering status, and then I'll mass charge them. Thoburn was killed, so there's my two-officer minimum limit for this side battle. Rather than a two-drink minimum, many side battles have a two-officer minimum. The AI units are in poor enough shape that I'm going to charge everyone and finish this battle, hopefully with some captures. I'll send my infantry first and then time my cav to arrive right about the same time. I got four of them plus the supply wagon, so it was a good finish. I hit 796 men killed, 2,228 wounded, and 318 missing for a total of 3,342 casualties. The AI had 10,398 casualties and 3,132 men captured. Pickett was wounded and Thoburn was killed, and my supply officer was promoted to major. The AI cavalry must have had Colt pistols. The artillery batteries were medium guns. Thank you so much for spending some of your valuable time watching today. I hope you found something useful for your campaigns. And I wish you much success, generals.